Hello class 9th. Today we are going to start with the lesson 4, Rise of Assertive Nationalism. In the previous lesson, we have discussed the period of early nationalists. That was a period from 1885 to 1905. In lesson number 3, we came to know about the famous nationalists. Early nationalists like Dadabhai Naroji, S.N. Banerjee, Gopal Krishna Gokhale, and their contributions, their methods, and their achievements. As you know, early nationalists demanded Swaraj through constitutional means, which were against the violent method, as they were have the full faith in the British sense of justice. But, sorry to say, the British government discarded all constitutional methods. Nothing productive came out of it. Today, we will discuss the second phase of early nationalists, that is from 1905 to 1916, where the young leaders of the Congress change the mode of their struggle. The rise of assertive radicals or nationalism, main objectives, introduction, causes of assertive nationalism, principles of assertive nationalism, methods of assertive nationalism, achievements of assertive nationalism, difference between the early nationalist and the assertive nationalist. Today we will discuss the topic, the introductory part or initial part of the chapter, that is introduction. Before discussion of the topic, we must know the following term, assertive radicals. Having or showing the forceful personality who are able to get their rights without upsetting others. Nationalism, love for your own country. Appeal, make a serious, urgent and heartful request. Futility. Lack of importance, resources is a source from which a benefit is produced. Self-rule, Swaraj. Now, as you know, children, that the history of national movement can be divided into the three phases. First phase that has lasted from 1885 to 1905. Second phase lasted from 1905 to 1919. Third phase lasted from 1919 to 1947. In the previous lesson, lesson number 3, we have discussed the first phase. Now we will discuss the second phase, that is 1905 to 1919. In this part, we will discuss the second phase from 1905 to 1919. As we know, in 1905, partition of Bengal has taken place. 1919, Jallianwala Bagh massacre held. This period from 1905 to 1919 as the period of the assertive nationalist. As we know, the assertive nationalist, because they have different outlook that advocated the active resistance to the British imperialism. Imperialism means when the strong country ruling over weak country. Moreover, they called upon the people of India to make sacrifices for the sake of their country. Now let's come to the reading part. Lesson 4, Rise of Assertive Radical Nationalism. During the period of 1885 to 1905, the Congress depended on the constitutional means of appeals, as we have discussed, and prayers to get their demands accepted. Since they were against the violent methods, who? The early nationalists. Because it firmly believed that British sense of justice and fair play, but the government discarded its appeals and nothing concrete come out of it. Means government had bothered nothing about it and no solid or productive came out of it, and they have to change the mode of their struggle. As we know, during the period of 1885 to 1905, the Congress depended on the constitutional means of appeal and prayer to get its demand, but the government discarded its appeals and nothing concrete come out of it. The young leaders of the Congress realized the futility of the constitutional means and the policy of loyalty and begging adopted by early nationalists, but they wanted to achieve Swaraj through assertive radical means and continuous struggle. They came to be known as assertive nationalists. The most prominent assertive nationalists were Bal Gangadhar Tilak, Lala Lajpat Rai, Bipin Chandra Pal. They were famous as Lal Bal Pal Trio. Moreover, there were many causes for the rise of assertive nationalists. like failure of early nationalist, reactionary policy of Lord Curzon, repressive policies of British government, partition of Bengal, ill treatment with the Indians, international events. Now let's come to the reading part. The young leaders of the Congress like Tilak, Lala Lajpat Rai and Bipin Chandra Pal realized the futility of the constitutional means and the policy of loyalty and beggary adopted by the early nationalists. Means whatever the methods adopted by the early nationalists, they did not produce any concrete solution. They believed in the assertive radical form of nationalism. Nationalism means love for your own country. They wanted to achieve Swaraj. Swaraj means self-rule through the assertive radical means and continuous struggle. They came to be known as assertive radical nationalists as they dominated and guided the national movements from 1905 to 1919. Or we can say the assertive nationalists were those, they were the dominating leaders from the period 1905 to 1919. Just have a look on the pictures. Lala Lajpat Rai, Bal Gangadhar Tilak, Bipin Chandra Pal. They were known as the assertive nationalist. These three leaders constituted the trio. Trio means group of three leaders and led the national movement in the early years of 20th century. So this period is called the period of assertive radical nationalism in the history of national movements. Now children, today we will do till here. By tomorrow we will do the causes one by one. As we discussed, till that you will have to reread this part again and learn the following terms. Thank you.